this ADU right behind me cost $155,000. I'm gonna show you the finished product. If you've seen the video of this ADU under construction and you wanna see the finished product, I'm gonna do that today. Thank you, the owner gave me access to film the finished product, so thank you once again. I know everybody's been looking at this ADU. It's probably one of the best ADUs I've seen so far. Everything is new construction. The floor, the framing, the footings, the roof. This was a project all the way from zero to now. I believe at this point, he's got the final signature to get the certificate of occupancy, and he's done. He can start moving in tomorrow. So let's take a look. Let's see what we have. The cool feature about this ADU is that you have the livable space on one side. The door over there connects the house with the deck, and this is a legal permitted deck, and it features a bathroom. So all of this had to go through planning and building and safety for the city to allow this kind of construction. And for this particular city, they allow it. I don't know if they would allow this in any other city, but over here they were okay with it. This is the bathroom, the vanity, the toilet, very cool shower. You can see there's tile all the way to the top. And to be new construction, the overall budget was very tight. He managed, I think he went over budget by about maybe 15,000 bucks, but you're getting a whole new building. You're getting a big house for a really good price. We're gonna step inside. This is one way to get into the property. The other way is through the doors on this section. Brand new drywall. The floor is a laminate floor. We have another sliding door on this side. The vaulted ceiling with a fan in the middle. The recessed lights. One cool feature that you might not find in other ADUs is the vents for the AC. As you can see, it's just one whole piece from the beginning all the way to the end. And it's the same thing on the other side. It's just one big slim piece. I would say it's a luxury finish. They're more expensive, but as you can tell, it's worth the money. Right over here, we have the kitchen. Initially, there was gonna be an island somewhere over here, but the owner just went with a small table on the side. And we have the shaker cabinets, all the shaker cabinets, brand new. The owner of this property didn't use the normal route to build. He did kind of what I did and hired different companies to do specific jobs. He hired somebody for the framing, a different company for the foundation, an electrician, there's a plumber. And this way he managed to get the best deal for his buck. And something like this, if you go with a general contractor, most likely is gonna be about $250,000, maybe all the way up to $300,000. That was a tour of the kitchen and the living room. Now let me take you into the bedroom. We have the two-tone colors, a lighter color on the walls, and then white on the top. We have the recessed lights, the vinyl windows. I like the finish. You don't have trim on the windows. It gives it more of a minimalistic look, which is what I have on my ADU. We have a lot of electrical plugs all the way around. Most likely, this is where the bed is going to be. So on each side of the bed, you're gonna have an outlet to charge your phone. I was having a conversation with the owner, and he said that he bought these doors from the same store that I bought my doors. I liked the look. Once I saw the doors, I knew they were not from Home Depot. They were from somewhere expensive. And they look nice. This is the first door coming in. It has the same look for the door to the bathroom. And this is the door for your closet. For an ADU to have a walk-in closet, I consider it a luxury. You have this big, massive space to put all your stuff. Nowadays, when people are buying a house, they want a two-car garage, walk-in closets, and three bedrooms and two baths. That's the minimum things that people want. And one of the things being a walk-in closet, to have that in your ADU is a massive plus. Let me give you a tour of the bathroom. We have tile on the floor, tile on the bathroom, a big window for natural light. One of the things that I noticed was this shower head. This is pretty cool. It's sticking out maybe 2 feet out from the wall. This is the vanity with two faucets. There's a lot of space. And right over here, you're gonna have the washer and dryer. Dryer goes over there. The washer goes over here. Just like with anything, electricians, like plumbers, their prices are all over the place. Nobody has a set price. Everybody's gonna give you a different price, and it's just a mess. But what I would say is interview a lot of electricians, a lot of plumbers. You're gonna get a pattern. You're gonna have quotes that are really high, and then quotes that are medium, and then just low quotes. So at the end of the day, it doesn't really matter who does the work as long as they're a licensed company. If it's a licensed company, all the work has to pass the inspection. That way you're gonna be comfortable because the inspector is gonna look at the work, and then the licensed contractor is gonna have to do the work up to code. So just talk to a lot of electricians, find somebody that's gonna give you a deal, and just go with that guy. I would add to that, get somebody who gives you a good deal and somebody that you're gonna have a good time with. Because, I mean, if you hire a contractor that you don't like, you're gonna have an awful time. But if you hire somebody that you feel comfortable with working, you're hitting all the check boxes at that point. If you saw the video of this property under construction, this was just a bunch of wood. There was nothing installed. There was some plumbing, but nothing like this. Now the water heater has been installed. All the copper pipes have been installed. You have your gas line right over here with the shut-off valve. Same thing for the water. This is the water. And right over here, you're gonna have the shut-off valve, an electrical plug for your water heater, and an additional plug in case you wanna plug in some, I don't know, Christmas lights or a fan or a TV. That's another clean out. This is new construction. The building is 1,000 square feet. The living space is about 700 square feet. I have to say, this is a luxury ADU. It's not a standard construction. This is something really nice. You can, you know, just sit there and have a margarita and then just jump into the pool. That's what I would do. One of the cool things that I like about this ADU is the way that the doors open. The whole door can be opened, and that way you can enjoy the pool from the inside of the house. So how much does all this cost, right? Everybody just wants to know the price. Everybody just wants to know, how much is it? How can I build it? Who are your contractors? It's a tough scenario. I mean, every property is different. Every owner has different ideas. Every budget is gonna be different. This particular ADU, the original budget the owner had was about 140. And then things like any project, they kind of start to pile up. At the end of the day, he spent about 155 for the entire project, 155. If this was being built by one contractor doing everything, you'll be looking at $250,000 to $300,000. So by him doing it himself, he managed to save almost half. And for the finishes that he chose, I mean, it doesn't make sense to hire somebody and pay more money when at the end of the day, he got the higher finishes for a way better price. And for people who are thinking about doing their own ADU, just don't hesitate. It is tough. It's a bumpy road, but it pays off. I mean, this ADU, I mean, this, it's completed, it's done. The owner took it upon himself to do it himself, hire different companies, doing different jobs. And if something happens, if it's not done correctly, you don't have to worry.
the city inspector is gonna come by, look at the work, and approve the work. If the work is not done properly, he won't approve it, and it won't get built. So you have a lot of safety barriers that you have to go through in order to go from one step to the other. So there you go, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like it, subscribe, and if you want to look at more ADU videos, follow the channel. Follow the channel. I appreciate every single viewer. Every time somebody looks at a video, it's, you know, thank you. You're helping the channel grow, and I don't know what to say. See you guys in the next one.